The one then who looks at the asalib and the approach of the Messenger وسلم, with dealing with disputes will understand, ikhwan, it is not just about you must remain quiet and listen to me, and everything that I say is final. We do have, without doubt, instances of akhd wa rad. The Messenger وسلم, would have this back and forward between himself and his wives. He would consult with them. The Messenger والسلام, consulted with his wives on numerous occasions, and we have that recorded. And that goes against the hadith that is da'if, ikhwan. شَاوِرُوهُنَّ وَخَالِفُوهُنَّ Hadith that is weak, in fact fabricated. Consult with them and then oppose them. And you consult with them and whatever they tell you to do, do the opposite. Hadith that is da'if. Rather, the Messenger of Allah took the consultation of his wives on an occasion when and during the affair of the Sulh of Hudaybiyah. The Prophet ﷺ, when they had entered the region of Hudaybiyah, which was outside of Mecca, when they intended to enter for Umrah, Prophet ﷺ saw in a dream that they would make Umrah after the migration and what have you, and they had been in Medina for a period, for those years, and had not made Umrah. The Prophet ﷺ saw in a dream that they would make Umrah. And so, the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he set out with his companions to make Umrah. When they reached the outskirts of Mecca, they were prevented by the Kuffar of Quraysh. They heard that they were coming, and so they said, no, we're not going to allow them to come. And they came and stopped them before they even reached Mecca. In that region, because of the ongoing conflict that was going on between themselves, the believers and the disbelievers, the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he, in this instance, number one, he consulted with his companions first and foremost, and he addressed the Kuffar of Quraysh. And this was during a period of dispute. The Kuffar of Quraysh, they agreed to settle with the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam upon a number of terms and conditions that they would agree to and that they would work upon futuristically, that would prevent bloodshed and would prevent warfare. And so, from the terms and conditions that occurred during this pact, there were terms that would apparently, or that seemed to go against the believers. If there was a person in Mecca that wanted to migrate to the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, then if they left Mecca and migrated to the Messenger of Allah, the Prophet ﷺ would have to send them back. And people were still being persecuted who had not left. And there was during that time an individual known as Abu Jandal. And Abu Jandal was one that was being persecuted. He was in chains and fetters. He was chained up. He attacked the one who had chained him, escaped. When he heard that the Prophet ﷺ was on the borders of Mecca, he escaped, he reached the Messenger of Allah ﷺ, and he fell on his knees in chains in front of the Messenger of Allah ﷺ during the Pact of Hudaybiyah. And so the Prophet ﷺ, based upon the agreement to this pact, had to send him back. And the companions, they said it was a difficult day. And so they would refer to it as Yawm Abi Jandal. Yawm Abi Jandal. The day of Abu Jandal. And if they had to send him back. Imagine, ikhwan. Persecuted, probably harmed, probably bleeding. Then he comes believing that you're going to save him. And here is the Messenger, here are the believers, alhamdulillah. The Prophet ﷺ had to send him back. And so naturally this caused some of the companions to be upset. From them, Umar radiallahu anhu. So Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, Ya Rasulullah, are they not the disbelievers? He said, yes. And are we not he went to Abu Bakr first. He said, are we not the believers? Afwan, he went to the Prophet first. He said, are we not the believers? He said, yes. He said, are they not the disbelievers? He said, yes. He said, so why are we taking or accepting a lesser deal or a lesser agreement? Prophet said, I'm the messenger of Allah. And so he went to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And he said, Ya Abu Bakr, are they not the kuffar? He said, yes. He said, are we not the believers? He said, yes. He said, so why are we accepting a lesser deal or a lesser agreement? He said, that is the messenger of Allah. And so the day, Ikhwan, was a day that was difficult. They had expected that the dream of Allah, this is the manifestation of the dream. لتدخلن المسجد الحرام إن شاء الله آمنين محلقين رؤوسكم ومقصرين لا تخافون فعلم ما لم تعلموا. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned, verily Allah Azza wa Jal, لقد صدق الله رسوله الرؤيا بالحق. Allah Azza wa Jal had given the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, his messenger, a true dream. لتدخلن المسجد الحرام إن شاء الله. You shall certainly enter the Masjid al-Haram, insha'Allah, amineen, in safety and security. Muhalliqina ru'usakum wa muqassirina la takhafoon. Shaving your heads or trimming them, having no fear. Meaning, yani the completion of Umrah. And so this that was seen by the messenger in a dream, they decided they are going to make it manifest. And so they had set out from Medina to Mecca for Umrah. That is what we set out for, and that is what we're going to do. So when they were stopped, and when the Pact of Hudaybiyah took place, from the terms, again, those terms that apparently went against them, from those terms, we have the mention of if anyone from the people of Medina, from those who had made the migration, wanted to return and go back to Mecca, Prophet ﷺ could prevent them. He had to let them go. And if anyone from Mecca wanted to go and join the Messenger of Allah, Prophet ﷺ had to send them back. But the Prophet ﷺ knew from his wisdom that in it was khair, in it was good. This period of peace, they were able to give da'wah, they were able to call to Allah, they were able to propagate the deen without fearing. And that is what took place. It was a beneficial period. But in any case, because of the fact that they had not reached Mecca, they had their animals, they were in Ihram, it was Umrah. That is what you saw, Messenger of Allah. That is what we're going to do. And so the Prophet ﷺ, after the pact, Prophet ﷺ announced to them that we're not going to be able to make Umrah. From them were those who said, oh, Messenger of Allah, you saw it in a dream. You saw that we were going to make Umrah. And so he said, we're not going to make Umrah. We're going to shave here and we're going to come out of Ihram. And so this is for them. Remember, Ikhwan, this is not just a quick plane journey or a bus trip. This is Mecca to Medina. It's a mishwar, it's a distance. And slow riding camels and slow donkeys and what have you. And so by the time they got to Mecca, as far as they were concerned, this was, we're going to make Umrah. And so this was difficult for some of them, Ikhwan. And so the Prophet ﷺ entered upon his wife and said that none of them want to shave, and none of them are slaughtering their animals. What should I do? And so she, radiallahu anha wa ardaha, she said, Ya Rasulullah, you shave your head. Go out to them, you shave your head, and you slaughter your animal. Yeah, so that they will know categorically the affair is over here and this is what we should be doing. And so he took her advice. He went out to them, he shaved his head in front of them. And he slaughtered his animal in front of them, and immediately each and every one of them began to fulfill and to carry out that which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had, number one, commanded them with, and number two, that he himself had fulfilled. And so, Ikhwan, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not only would he deal with the dispute in that manner, but he likewise would accept the advice of his wife if the advice was wajib, if the advice was good. And so there is no problem with that, there is no issue with that. And that is something, ikhwan, that again, sometimes with some of our brothers, that we have difficulty accepting from our wives. And as far as the women are concerned, likewise, we have some women who have difficulty accepting from their husbands. Even though the origin, the asal and the origin, is that the husband has more right to be listened to and to be obeyed than his wife has right to be listened to and obeyed, if we're going to weigh up the two of them.